Hello, welcome to PLK Computers or YouTube channel. In this tutorial video, we are going to discuss about Chapter 3 Input Output Devices. Outline of Chapter 3. Number 1, recognize the input output devices. Number 2, describe the basic functions of different types of input output devices. Number 3, find or select the right input output devices as they are required. Number 4, mention the difference between soft copy and hard copy output devices. Number 5, introduce different types of printer and their basic working principles and use. Number 6, recognize the different types of ports and expansion slots. Past questions from Chapter 3. Number 1, what are pointing devices? Number 2, differentiate between mouse and trackball. Number 3, what is barcode, where it is used? Number 4, what is printer? Number 5, differentiate between impact and non-impact printers. Number 6, what is the use of plotter? Number 7, define soft copy output devices. Number 8, write short notes on Number A, touch screen. Number B, trackball. Number C, scanner. Number D, barcode reader, BCR. Number E, joystick. Number F, MICR. Now we are going to start lesson 3. So input devices, definition of input devices: an electromechanical device that allows the user to feed data and instruction into the computer for analysis, storage, and to give commands to the computer is called input device. Okay, so electromechanical, so electricity also needed, and mechanical, like you should press, or like a keyboard you should press over there. Mouse, if you talk, then mouse is also mechanical because we have to move, like I am rotating, that's why it is moving. It's mean both electricity and movement is needed. So mechanically movement is also needed in input devices. Example of input devices are keyboard, mouse, touch pad, joystick, scanner, barcode reader. And in this lesson we are going to discuss these devices in details. Functions of input devices: an input device performs the following functions. Number 1, it will accept or read the data and instruction from the user. Number 2, it converts these inputs in the computer acceptable form, that is binary code 0 and 1 form. It will convert the accepted data. And number 3, it supplies the converted input to the computer system for further processing, which are stored temporarily in RAM. So RAM is known as volatile memory, so temporarily currently being used data will be saved under RAM. Now we are going to discuss the most famous input device, that is keyboard. A keyboard is the most common input device. Using a keyboard, the user can type text and execute commands. So both we can do, we can type as well as we can execute commands. A keyboard is designed to resemble a regular typewriter with a few additional keys. So it will just like typewriter, but we have more additional keys. Data is entered into the computer by simply pressing various keys of the keyboard. The layout of a keyboard is found in various styles, but QWERTY is the most common layout. Okay, so in upper row of the alphabet there will be Q, W, E, R, T, Y, U, I, O, P, curly braces, accordingly it will be. So this is the most common layout. Keyboard continue. The layout of the keyboard has been changed very little ever since it was introduced. So time by time, keyboard layout is being changed. The number of keys on a keyboard varies from 82 keys to 108 keys. Okay, so in simple, there will be 82, and if multimedia, more advanced keyboard, then there can be 108 keys. Portable computers such as laptop quite often have custom keyboard that have slightly different key arrangements from a standard keyboard. Okay, so in our laptop, the function key, the num key, it will be different. Even it will be smaller in size than a standard keyboard which we use in desktop computer. So the main thing, layout will be also different. Okay, so in laptop and in desktop keyboard, so in laptop it will be inbuilt keyboard. Okay, in desktop by outside we have to join. Now pointing device are the important devices by which we can put out and select the we can point out and select the items rapidly from the multiple options displayed on the screen. So we can choose from the menu. These devices can also be used to create graphic element on the screen such as line, curves and freehand shape. So my dear students, so using MS Paint you have typed many drawing, okay, with the help of pointing device like mouse. Okay, pointing device continue. The common types of pointing device available are number A, mouse, number B, trackball, number C, joystick, number D, touch screen, number E, light pen, number F, touchpad. Okay, so one by one we are going to discuss this. So number A, mouse. A mouse is a small handheld pointing device which is used to create graphic elements on the screen such as line, curves and freehand shapes. Okay, so in MS Paint, in other application also, we can make different types of drawing like line, curves or freehand shape. It is also used to run a program and pull down a menu in GUI, that is graphical user interface based computer system, like in Windows 10. Right now we are clicking on icon and opening. Simply in Microsoft Word, clicking on file menu, save, like that. It is rectangular shaped with a rubber ball embedded at its lower side and button on the top. Okay, so down there will be a rubber ball and on top it will be button. Usually a mouse contains two or three buttons which can be used to input commands or instruction. Okay, so left button, right button. Okay, similarly in middle also there will be some mouse. Okay, otherwise there will be slider. The mouse may be classified into two categories on the basis of technology, so mechanical mouse and optical mouse. Now mechanical mouse. A mechanical mouse uses a rubber ball at the bottom surface which rotates as the mouse is moved along a flat surface to move the cursor. Okay, so we have to move on the flat surface. Okay, then ball will rotate downward, accordingly cursor will move like this. It is the most common and least expensive pointing device. Okay, so it is cheaper in cost. IBM and Logitech are some well-known products of the mechanical mouse. So these are the manufacturers. Okay, so in previous time it was used a lot, but nowadays maximum we use optical mouse. An optical mouse uses a light beam instead of a rotating ball to detect the movement across a specially patterned mouse pad. Okay, so instead of the ball there will be light. According to reflection of light it will works. As the user rolls the mouse on a flat surface, the cursor on the screen also moves in the direction of the mouse movement. Just now I am moving and it is coming like this, okay? So it is more expensive in comparison with the mechanical mouse. So optical is expensive in comparison to mechanical. Modern optical mouse are accurate and often do not need a mouse pad, okay? So without mouse pad also we can easily use the optical mouse. Number B, trackball. A trackball is another pointing device that uses a ball which is settled in a square cradle. Okay, so it will be located in the keyboard. Okay, so in especially to the GH key, on that location it will be located. In general, a trackball is just like an upside down turn mouse. Okay, so we can move it up down. The ball is rolled by finger to move the cursor around the screen. So we can use our finger to rotate the cursor. Trackball continue. A trackball require less space than a mouse for operation because the whole device is not moved for moving the cursor. Okay, like mouse we need big space, okay, but this trackball does not need. It is often attached to or inbuilt into the keyboard. Okay, so on the small computer keyboard like laptop, notebook, okay, so in that keyboard it will be inbuilt. The trackball built into the keyboard are commonly used in laptop, notebook, computer because the mouse is not practical for laptop user in a small space. Okay, so for the small space, if we keep the mouse, then it won't be good due to small size of this laptop notebook. It works like a mouse, so its main function is similar to mouse. This is the difference between mouse and trackball. Good question for your examination point of view. Number one, a mouse is a small handheld pointing device which is used to create graphical elements on the screen. Similarly, trackball is a pointing device that uses a ball which is settled in a square cradle. Okay, especially trackball will be inbuilt in keyboard, but mouse will be outside. Mouse require more space than a trackball, and trackball require less space than a mouse. That's why trackball is especially used in laptop or notebook computers. Number C, joystick. A joystick is a device that moves in all directions and controls the movement of the cursor on the screen. The joystick offers three types of control. So three: number one, digital control; number two, glide control; number three, direct control. Okay, so digital control allows movement in a limited number of directions, such as up, down, left and right in the four directions. Glide and direct controls offer the movements in all directions. Okay, so in 360 degree we can rotate. Joystick continue. The basic design of a joystick consists of a stick that is attached to a plastic base with a flexible rubber seat. It has some pushing button and a circuit board which is placed under a stick. Joystick are mainly used for computer games, controlling industrial robots, and for other applications such as flight simulator, training simulator, etc. Okay, so especially for the gaming purpose this joystick is used. Okay, so we can rotate in left, right or up, down. Okay, now number D, light pen. A light pen is a handheld electro-optical pointing device which is connected to the computer by a cable. Okay, so through cable it light pen will be connected. When it touches the connected computer monitor, it will allow the computer to determine where on that screen the pen is pointed. So it will realize the pen pointer. It facilitates drawing images and select objects on the display screen by directly pointing to the object with the pen. So especially for the drawing purpose, this light pen is used. Light pen continue. Light pen gives the user the full ranges of mouse capabilities without using the pad and any horizontal surface. Using light pen, the user can interact more easily with application in such mode as dragging and dropping or highlighting. Okay, so just like pen, how we write in paper, similarly we can write on the monitor. It is very popular for graphic work in engineering like CAD, computer aided design. So engineer will make drawings like building, bridges, okay, before the construction according to the client's order. Number 8, touch screen. Or touch screen is a special kind of display screen device which is placed on the computer monitor in order to allow the direct selection or activation of the computer's information when somebody touches the screen. So by touching it will works. Essentially, it registers the input when a finger or the object touches the screen. So accordingly, the touching moment, it will register the object, which object is being touched. Touch screen continue. Touch screen is normally used to access the information with minimum effort. Okay, so we don't we have to press hard. Okay, very easily we can use the touch screen. However, it is not suitable for input of a large amount of data. Okay, that's why like if you have to type lots of thing, then keyboard will be effective. Okay, laptop will be effective than in mobile device. Suppose nowadays maximum mobile device is coming in touch screen method. Okay, typically they are used in information providing system like hospital, airline, railway reservation counter, amusement parks. Okay, for those and especially in the token purpose, also in banking if you go over the years. Okay, so or that place touch screen. So with the minimum effort we are getting the output. And nowadays all the mobile device, it is coming in touch screen rather than the keyboard system. Okay, so touch pad. Okay, we'll discuss this in the next video. Thank you very much for watching. Please like, subscribe PLK Computer Sir, and wait for the next video. Thank you very much.